Hello friends, welcome to TechMime, my YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to see about data manipulation. In the previous last three videos, I have explained about Pandas, NumPy and Matplotlib. So here, how we use this in the real time. So I'm giving many examples in this video. So please watch the full video. Let's get into the video. Okay. For that, I'm import Pandas as PD and NumPy as NP. So this is a common thing. And Matplotlib.pyplot as PLT. Okay. So first thing, I'm passing arrays in series. Pandas, I mean pd.series, and I'm passing four different values in an array. So you can check ndim. This is common thing. In the previous video itself, I have explained ndim is used to check the dimension. If you check the axis, see start is 0, stop is 4, and step is 1, and then you can check the values array of what is the value and what is the data type that will display. And I am taking a library here, okay? So keys and values. So key will be odd and even. NP dot a range, okay. NP dot a range 1, 100, and step is 2. So in between 1 and 100, the step is 2. And even values I'm taking NP dot a range 0, 100, and the step is 2. Okay. So if I take this into data frame of D, if I run this, you can see the output values here, odd numbers as well as even. See, this is odd number 1, 3. Okay, so it's getting printed till 99 since I'm taking 100, and 50 rows are there, two columns, one is odd, other one is even, like the key will be considered as column name. Okay, so I have a data frame right now. So if you wanted to see, the data frame is huge, you have 50 rows, right? You wanted to get only first 5 rows. In this case, what you can do, you can use df.head. When you use df.head, by default it will take only the first 5 data, I mean rows. Okay, in this data frame it will take only first 5 rows. So I'm using df.head. You can see the output here, 0 to 4 is the index values, and you can see the inside whatever the values are given. Okay, you can mention I want only 2 rows, first and, I mean 0th index and first index. Likewise, you can mention, if you mention 2, it will give only 2 rows. Such a way. Now I told you how to take the rows which is starting from the beginning, like first row, second row, 0th row, right? 0th index row. If you wanted to take the last row of the data frame, what you have in that situation, you have to use tail. If you use tail without passing any parameter, it will give you the last five rows in the data frame. Or if you want, you can give values, like I have given 2, so it is like last 2 rows, 48 and 49 will be printed as an output. Okay. And the other thing, you can sum the complete columns, whatever the value you have odd and even, 2 different columns. If you want, you can sum all the values. I'm just doing df.sum. See, odd is 2500 and even is 2450, data type is integer, int 64. Well, sum all the values available in the data frame. Okay. And then df.sum axis equal to 1. So here addition row wise, okay, you are doing addition row wise, like what you have to understand here, it will add 1 plus 0 is 1, 3 plus 2 is 5, 5 plus 4 is 9, 7 plus 6. If you see the output here, see 1, 5, 9, 13. So it will add both the columns and it will give in this format. Okay, so you can add. For that, you just have to mention axis equal to 1. If you mention 0, it will display both the columns. Okay, and then dfpd.read.csv, I'm loading a file what I have right now, and see, let me show you the file.csv is my file. Okay, look at this file. So these are the values I have, like name, age, country and job. These are the 5 different columns I have, and I have given the values for the same. So including the header, 8 rows will be there. So if you see this, I'm giving df, and I'm giving df.sum. In this case, see, all the numbers are added together and it is telling it's 28, and all the names, Sam, Kocher, Vince, John, so this all became together, and age is also added. The column wise, all the datas will be added and it will give you the total values. Okay, so even for string, it is giving the added values, and whenever string is involved, then the d type will be object. Okay, if you are using only integer, it will show as int or float. If you are giving float values, else if string is being involved, then it will display as an object. Okay, and if you want, you can do it separately also. I'm df of age dot sum, it will add only age, and you can check std. So df of age comma std. Std means standard deviation, and then you can check the mean of the age. This is the mean value, and then minimum value, what is the minimum value and maximum value. This all you can check. If you wanted to check all the available function, then you just have to do directory of df, this data frame. It will tell you all the available functions you can perform, and you can try out whenever you get time. Okay. And then, yeah, I hope this concept is clear. These are very basic things. I don't need to explain once again. Okay, so it's very easy to understand. So IT or ITER items, which means iterating over items. I have a random value that I have generated. I want to iterate over all the values, right? So you look at this line of code. I'm creating a data frame here directly. So df equal to pd.dataframe of np. I wanted to generate random values, right? So that is the reason I'm using numpy. numpy.random rand n 5,4 means 5 rows will be there and 4 columns will be there. That is the meaning of 5,4. It will generate random values, random array it will generate. Okay, so see, this is what the random values which is generated, like 5 rows, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 columns are there. So column name I can define here by using the column keyword, column equal to ABCD. Okay, so if you run this, see, this is the data frame that I have created, ABCD, 4 columns and 5 rows will be there with index. Okay, so here I'm using ITER items for columns name and column val. Okay, column name and column val in df dot, this is my data frame, so I'm giving df dot ITER items. Okay, so print column name and column value, and so to give a differentiation, I'm giving this print hashtag into 15 means it will print hashtag for 15 times. If you run this, look at this, column wise the data will be printed. I mean, each and every separate item will be printed. Let me tell you. So this is the A column. Okay, so in A column, whatever the value is available, you can see here name is A, D type is float, and such a way for B, such a way for C and D, separate, the column values are printed here. Okay, so say in the same way you can iterate over rows. Now I have shown you how to iterate items, which means if you have a set of data, like in a real-time example, if you take, this is also for your understanding purpose, I have given this data, it's a randomly generated value. So if you wanted to get only age, only city, only country, or only the phone number, in this case you can take only the column, extract only the column from the data file what you have. Okay, so iterate rows such a way, I have 1000 users, I wanted to fetch only Sam information, where he is working, what is his age, what is his phone number, I wanted to get only his information. In that time you can iterate over particular rows, or you wanted to pass the value one by one, then you can iterate over rows. Okay, so same concept applied here. I'm creating another data frame, same 5x4 range. Yeah, I copy pasted the same. So what I'm doing here, look at this, row index comma value. If you look at in column, it will be column name comma column value. So here it will be row index comma value in df.iter rows, and print row index and value. So it will print the index as well as value. So 0th index, what is available, 1 2 3 4 4 different data, like this, starting from 0.9, 0.2, 2.0, 0.8. look at this first row values are printed like this. So what is the row index, such a way second will be first index, second index, third index, fourth index, and the row wise value. So since it is given in float, look at the data type, it is float. Okay, so this is how you can get iterate over rows. And ITR tuple, so accessing the column for each row. Okay, so let me explain you this. For row in df.iter tuple, same thing, this is how you have to use ITER items, ITER rows, ITER tuple, row dot A comma row dot B. So I wanted to get the values available for all the index, like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, only A and B column values I need, not C and D. Okay, so if you run this, see, this is the A value for 0, see, 0th index, first one is 0th index, A value and B value, and first index A value, B value, second index A value, B value, right? So this is how you can get the row, and you can specifically take a row. I want only these two information. I'm taking Sam's name, I want only his age and phone number, right? This time you can use the ITER tuple. Okay, so to extract only the required information. So now we are going to see the most important concept in data manipulation, which is group by operations. Okay, so which means accessing a group of values in a file. So I'm importing pandas as pd. I'm creating a dictionary, so called team, rank and year. These are the key values, okay, which means this will be taken as column name. I'm passing the values inside: West Indies, Australia, okay, USA, Canada, and how many, what is the rank which they got and which year they got the ranking. I have passed. So I'm taking this into data frame of World Cup, okay. So DF, if I call, this is the data frame that I have created: West Indies rank 7 in which year, again West Indies rank 6 in which year, such a way for Canada rank 5 in which year, okay. So I am using the group by function, DF dot group by team. See, team, this is the column, dot groups, okay. So if you run this, look at this dictionary, what I have got the output. So Canada will be in the first position, 5, and USA it's 4, Australia it's in the second, okay, and then West Indies will be 0 and 1. So what you can understand, this is 5th index, 4th index, 2nd index, 3rd index and 0 and 1st index. So if you have names will be either, names will be same, right? I have two different West Indies. So it says it will be 0 and 1. Okay. Repeated values are in the same list. See, so this is how it will group. Okay. So I'm using only team here. If you want, you can use team and rank as well. When you use rank, it will check the order also. By default, it will calculate and it will display based on the order as well. Since I'm using only team, it's keeping it this order. Okay. And iterating over a group. So I have a group, I wanted to iterate over this group. So what I'm doing, for grp name comma grp value, which means group name and group value, in df.group by team, again I'm taking the same column, print group name and print group value. I'm giving a hashtag, like a asterisk, for 15 times to give you a difference, okay. So if you run this, it will print the separate values. Like, look at this, Canada, so team, rank, year, so index, including index, right? It will print the separate row values. It's a group, right? So Canada means, okay, this is a set of values. This year they want this, but this is the rank which they got, this is the index. So that will be printed separately. And the next one is USA, this is a group, and then Australia, and then Pakistan, and then West Indies. You can see 0th and 1st index, it is repeated 2 times. I have formed a group here that I'm calling here. So this is the iteration over a group, okay. So same concept earlier I have shown, right? ITR, tuple ITR, rows ITR, items, such a way, group by. It's a similar operation, okay. And then accessing a single group, here every group is being printed. I wanted to access only a particular group. So group, these are the variable name that I'm giving. You can give anything that you want. Group equal to df.group by team. I'm grouping, taking only team. And group dot get group, have taken in team, I have 5 different groups, so I have to get only one particular group. So I'm giving Canada. If you keep Canada and run, you will get the only Canada group values, right? This is how you can individually access one particular group, okay. So this is the concept about group by operation. Here concatenation, okay, this is also important concept. So I'm importing pandas, I'm creating a similar list, world champ and world champ 1, two different dictionaries I'm creating, not list, two different dictionaries I'm creating. So keys will be team year points, team year points, so different values I have passed, okay. So I'm taking this both into data frame. So if you print, see, this is the data frame 1 and data frame 2, right? So here what I'm doing, pd.concat df1 comma df2. So sort, it's not mandatory. If you want, you can give. If you want this to be in a sorted order, I'm giving sort equal to true. So this, see, look at this, 0 1 2 3 4 0 1 2 3 4 is here, and the second data frame got added in the, it's like extended what you already have, this got extended. So this is the second data frame, 0 1 2 3 4, these are the values. So finally you have a new data frame right now, right? So that is, this is the purpose we use concat function here, concatenation, okay. So this is one method. And method two will be what you can do. New df, I'm saving in this variable df1.append of df2. It will give you the same result. So you're appending the values. Okay. New df.loc of 0. So this is a new df what I have. I'm giving loc, which means I'm calling the values with label index. Okay. So I'm giving 0. So which are all zeros? Index 0. Here also 0th index. It will be India and Africa. So you will get only these values. Okay. So if you are giving ILOC, which means it will take only the first index value. So this is the 0th index, right? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You're getting my point. This has now become a label value. Okay. So index in front of this, again index will be there, since we have added this together. So that is the reason it is printing only one value, that is three, the first index, 0th index will be this one. 0333 India 1991. So you are getting that only that response. That as an output. Okay. So next will be adding the second data frame with column. Now I have shown how to add into the next row. Right. So now we have to add the column wise. One data frame will be on the left side, other data frame will be on the right side. See, look at this. So what you have to do. Again, same concat function, pd.concat, df1, df2. See what I did here, pd.concat, df1, df2, sort equal to true, I have given. So here you have to give access is equal to 1. When you make access is equal to 1, so see, it got added on the right side. Like column wise, the data got added, right? So this is the new data frame which you have got. And yeah, so that's all about concatenation, and then ITR items, ITR groups, that's all we have seen. Okay, so during school days you might have read about this Venn diagram, right? So look at this. This is A and this is B. So that is what I'm doing here. When I'm merging, it will give only these values. That is the reason I'm getting Australia and West Indies. In both the data frames, this value remains the same. Okay, so let me show you just a minute. Look at this. Here I have Australia, here also I have West Indies, and the same second data frame I have Australia as well as West Indies. So if I merge both of this, you will get only this common values. That is the reason. Look at the output, right? Okay, so next what I'm doing, I'm merging based on team. I'm using left, which means it will consider the values, the columns which is available on the left side. I will explain you how this works. Okay, so let me erase this. So A and B. So here left means this values will be considered. Left values will be considered. Okay, so if you look at the output, India, Australia, West Indies, Japan and China. Look at the data frame 1. India, Australia, West Indies, Japan and China, right? So team, year x and points x, here it ends, right? DF1 data frame 1 ends here. Look at this, team is a common, so year y and points y. For India it is NaN, for points also NaN, so whatever the common values available for that, it is giving the output. So which means it is merging from the left side. That is the logic here. The same category you can apply on the right side, merge on right. Okay, so here what you can do, take A and take B, or df1 df2. Here it will take the right side values, complete right side values. So look at this, I'm giving right here Africa, Australia, West Indies, New Zealand and Kenya. So look at the data frame 2. See Africa, Australia, West Indies, New Zealand and Kenya, right? See, those values are being printed. So look at this, year y and points y. So these are the values for actually for df2. For df1 it is empty. So Africa it is NaN, points it is NaN, remaining values are empty, right? So it is taking only from the right side. This is how the logic works on team, left and right. Okay, so here what I'm doing, one more function, like outer. So I am giving outer, not inner. Okay, so new data frame equal to pd.merge df1 comma df2 on team, based on team, how means outer values. Okay, so India, Australia, West Indies, Japan, China, these are the values of data frame 1. Africa, New Zealand, Kenya, so look at the data frame 2 here. Africa, New Zealand, Kenya. So here these two rows were excluded, Australia and West Indies, because it's considering only the outer values, because these values are already present, right? So it will consider only this values. Wait, let me erase this. So this is A. Sorry for the cross image. Okay, so it will consider only the outer values, right? It will consider only the outer values. Okay. So yeah, so I have given outer join, one value is being taken, so it is getting repeated, Australia and West Indies, so that is the reason again those values are not getting repeated. So now I have got a new data frame. Now I am going to give inner and on team remains the same. It will give the common values in both the data frame 1 data frame 2. This values will be printed, common values, only this values. This is how inner will work. Okay, right? So that's all about inner and outer, I mean merging and joining function. So if you have a data frame, I mean sorry, CSV file, please try out this. Okay, so next topic will be merging and joining. How to merge two different data frames, how to join two different data frames. This is what we are going to see. I just copy pasted the same code, the data is what I have created. I copy pasted here. I have taken this into data frame DF1, DF2. Okay, DF1 this is, DF2 this is the values. So I'm going to merge a specific column. Okay, I want to merge only specific column from this two different data frames. So I'm taking the values into new data frame. PD.merge is the function that I supposed to use, that is what I'm using. So DF1 comma DF2, on which basis I'm going to merge? On year basis. So merging means either it will give all the three values, but what if you have thousands of columns, you have thousand columns, you want to merge only particular columns in this. So in this situation you have to use on. So I'm giving on team, based on team merge this values. Okay, so if you run this, look at this, Australia and West Indies is the response that you are getting. I will tell you why. So here I have given an example. I have a file named allcountries.csv. This consists of 215 rows and 12 columns. Okay, I wanted to plot a pie chart only with GDP as well as country name. Look at this output, like GDP and country name, like this I wanted to get. But that what I supposed to do, I'm saving this in RD means relevant data. Okay, RD equal to data of GDP. Data is my this one file name. So data of GDP and country, I'm taking only these two rows. Okay, GDP and country in the name of RD. Okay, so SD means sorted data. Sorted data equal to relevant data dot sort. This is the relevant data, GDP and country. Here I'm giving using the sort function, sort values. Sort values by, based on what? So by GDP. Ascending is equal to false. I'm giving, if you want you can give, else you can give true. Ascending is equal to false. And select sorted data, so here I'm selecting only from 0 to 10th index. I need values. I have 215 rows, right? I don't want to take for all the rows, I want to take only for 10 rows. Okay, so I'm giving this and I'm plotting into pyplt dot py s select sorted data, which is x and label, not x, this percentage GDP, and label will be country. So if to get the percentage like this, end of the 12.98 it is coming, right? To get this format I'm using auto PCT dot 2f. If you want to get a round figure, then you can give percentage d. If you run this, this is the beautiful pie chart you will be getting. Okay, that's all about data manipulation in Python. We have seen the examples using pandas and matplotlib with many examples. So we'll see you in the next video. If you like this content, please do subscribe to our YouTube channel. Stay safe. Thank you. Bye-bye. And we'll see you in the next video about GUI programming. Okay. Bye-bye.